I'm gonna first tell you guys a little bit of the science, what's going on when you make Hollandaise sauce. So the proteins that are in eggs are in their native form like little balls. And they are shaped like this because of the type of bonds that are created, such as hydrophobic or hydrophilic bonds, or I should say amino acids. So proteins are essentially a chain of chemicals called amino acids. And those amino acids have different properties, whether they're hydrophilic or hydrophobic. Hydrophobic means that it's afraid of water, so it doesn't want to be around water. Hydrophilic is about liking water. It wants to be around it. So the way that the proteins orient themselves is that the hydrophobic amino acids like to be around other hydrophobic amino acids. And for that reason, the hydrophobic amino acids tend to be closer or inside the protein, whereas the hydrophilic are on the outside. So you create these tight little balls or packets of protein in the egg. Give me a second. I just need to take this out. Check my bacon. Yeah, bacon's good. So basically, as you heat, if you add heat or you add mechanical, which is whisking, or an acid, what will happen is that the bonds that hold the amino acids together will break apart. And then as they break apart, they begin to unravel and create kind of string or a denatured protein. So that protein creates like almost like little strands in the environment. And then as the heat is applied, or whatever you're adding, or mechanical, whatever, as that is happening, it's causing more vibration in the system. And eventually, like for like, will come back together. And then therefore, they will also trap water and air and these kind of things. And then you have a congealed or a cooked egg. The same principle is happening when we're making Hollandaise sauce. So first, I have proteins in these little ball forms. And then as I whisk them, or as I add heat, which I'll do through the poaching liquid, through steam, then what's gonna happen, it's gonna slowly denature those proteins into strands. And then the way that I know that the protein is denatured is that it will form ribbons on my whisk. And I'll show you that in a minute. So without further ado, let's get started. So basically, I'm just going to be whisking. You guys can't really see that too well. I'm just going to move this down. Guys, see that okay? So the key is taking your time when making Hollandaise sauce, because you don't want to overheat the eggs too fast so that they start to scramble. The whole process of denaturing the protein takes time. So basically having just a little bit of warm water and a bowl, and then just going back and forth, so you gently temper the eggs to allow them to thicken up. And that thickening is the egg protein. So now if I just show you, right now the egg protein is just, you just see drips. So this tells me that it's not denatured yet. I'm not at the state where I can then, when I'm at the state of denature, I then add the oil, and then with more whisking, that comes together into an emulsion. But this is not ready yet. So we gotta heat it up more. And this process, depending on how many egg yolks you have, can take between, I would say, 10 to 20 minutes. Yeah, you can see it's just drips. This is not what you want. You want that protein to be open so that when you add the oil or the clarified butter, that it comes together and creates a nice stable emulsion. That's how you make a Hollandaise sauce. So a bit of science and a bit of patience will be a reward for the sauce. I don't have a lot here because I don't want to make a lot today, because I'm pretty much doing it for myself, so. The key is to know if you're heating it up too much, is if you start seeing egg kind of like cook on the sides, that means your bowl is too hot. So you need to take it away from the heat to cool it down. And then once it's cool enough, then you put it back on the heat. It's just simply a game of hot and cold so that you maintain a stable temperature so that the protein can denature, but not overcook. You don't want that. You don't want the cooking to happen. You want it to open up. And right now, just by looking at it, I can see that the protein is starting to open up. It's starting to be a bit more ribbon. So it's a very, because I don't have a lot of egg yolks in here, it's gonna be very fast. If I have, let's say, 4 egg yolks, it's gonna take much longer because it requires more energy, more time to denature the protein. But here, I only have 1 egg yolk, so it's going to be very fast. So I have to be very careful not to overcook it. And I'm just going to turn this down so they don't heat it up too much. When making Hollandaise sauce, it's all about technique, but also what to look for in that technique. So it's more like, okay, now I can see it's really frothy. It's very creamy now. And also I see that when I put my whisk through it, that it's starting to leave trails, which is a good sign. But I'm not there yet with the ribbons. So I'm not at the ideal state. So I'm gonna try to get that going just by whisking and putting it on the heat. In this bowl, I literally dip it into the water so that I can get consistent heating throughout the entire process. Almost there. You can kind of see that it's still some drips, which is fine. Getting much thicker now. You can see that, like, it leaves impressions of the whisk inside the egg. So it means it's very close. There we go. So see that nice ribbon? It's one continuous ribbon. That's exactly where we want to be with the egg. Let's go a little bit further just to be sure I have all the protein denatured, and then we're going to add the oil. Yep. So that's the stage we want. That's the stage like I showed you earlier. The middle number 2 stage is the denatured protein stage. That's exactly where we want to be to start adding our oil for the Hollandaise sauce. And then when we add the oil, the protein will slowly continue to come together and form a nice, creamy emulsion. notice there's nothing cooked on the side of my bowl. So I just try to stay conscious of that. And now what I'll do is just move this to the side because I'm going to use it later. First, I'm going to take my bacon that I took out of the oven and I'm going to put it on some paper. So that's the bacon. That's a lot of work for science, right? I know. It's fun. I'm gonna try to warm this butter up a bit because I want to use it to. I want to use the heat of the clarified butter to keep the sauce warm. Now what I have here is I have a thermos that I've added hot water to, and this is where the Hollandaise sauce is going to be stored in. So I just take the hot water out, pour it out, like that. Easy peasy. Gonna dry it out. Nothing like some bacon for Sunday. Yeah, bacon's good. How are you doing today? I saw your you follow the channel. You missed the animation, so for you.
Yes, science.
Nice and warm. Just put that back on just to keep the heat down. Okay, so this is nice and melted now. Yep, it's good. Butter. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just whisk. And I'm gonna make an emulsion with my denatured protein. It's cooled down a bit, but it's okay, because I'm just gonna whisk in some of the clarified butter. The key is to making an emulsion is small oil droplets. So the best way to do that is by having as much whisking as possible. Normally in the factory, we have high speed pin beaters that can really get a very small bubble size. But for this, if you have a whisk that has a lot of tines, that's gonna give you a better emulsion. And I'm just adding the butter a few parts at a time and then just whisking it in to make the emulsion. And then when enough oil has been incorporated, I will add more of the clarified butter. But I don't want to add too much because I don't want it to break. If I add too much oil at the same time, it could, the emulsion could break apart. You can see it's still quite together. It's a good sign. Proteins were properly denatured, which is good. Very thick. This is a very thick sauce. This is much thicker than normally what Hollandaise sauce is, which is fine. We're gonna thin it out with some lemon juice in a minute. lot of work. Yes, Poppy, I know you want some. It's a very thick sauce, primarily because I had a lot of egg in there. So the amount of egg to butter in this recipe, there was more egg than butter, which is fine. Because I now can thin it out two different ways. I can add a little bit of water, or I can add lemon juice. Lemon juice also helps to add a bit of flavor. I'm also gonna add about a pinch of salt to season it. And I'm just gonna add some lemon juice. I'm gonna use a bit of the poaching liquid just to help thin out the sauce a bit, but it's not gonna be too much. It's very thick. I think I need more. Very thick one today. It's good. It's very stable. It's almost like mayonnaise if you look at it. Kind of looks like mayonnaise a bit. It's very thick. This is a very, so the way to thin it out is just, I'm just going to add some more water. Keep tasting it. Has a bit of acid in there. Tiny bit more salt. There is such a thing as over whipping or over emulsifying. So you have to be careful about that. So I need to be, I'm not gonna try to do it too much. I'm just gonna try to thin it out by just mixing in water. It's at a good consistency now. Just add a little bit more. Strange. I thought I was gonna be had enough. There we go. Okay, so what I'm looking for is this nice pourable consistency. That's what I want. That's what I got. So I have a nice pourable consistency. Add just a tiny bit more water because I'm going to put it into the thermostat, but it's going to also, as it sits, it becomes thicker, so I have to be sure that it doesn't do that. Let's do one more final taste. Look at that lemon juice. Lemon juice helps to cut through the fattiness because that's what acid does. That's it. Nope, it's good. So I'm gonna put that into my thermos. Turn that off. Mm. that kind of music is this? Langard, what's up, man? There we go. How you doing? Welcome, welcome. So, emulsion done in the thermos. Just close that up to keep it nice and warm.